in Nebraska. These two allegedly bore common characteristics of both man and ape. An extensive scientific debate began surrounding this fossil, which came to be called Nebraska Man, in which some interpreted this tooth as belonging to Pithecanthropus erectus, while others claimed it was closer to human beings. Nebraska Man was also immediately given a scientific name, Hesperopithecus heraldicus. Based on the single tooth, reconstructions of the Nebraska Man's head and body were drawn. Moreover, Nebraska Man was even pictured along with his wife and children as a whole family in a natural setting. All of these scenarios were developed from just one tooth. Evolutionist circles placed such faith in this ghost man that when a researcher named William Bryan opposed his biased conclusions, relying on a single tooth, he was harshly criticized. 5 years later, other parts of the skeleton were also found. According to these newly discovered pieces, the tooth belonged neither to a man nor to an ape. It was realized that it belonged to an extinct species of wild American pig. William Gregory, entitled the article published in Science magazine in which he announced the truth, Hesperopithecus, apparently not an ape nor a man. Then all the drawings of Hesperopithecus Harold Cookie and his family were hurriedly removed from evolutionary literature. Piltdown Man and Nebraska Man. These scandals demonstrate that evolutionary scientists do not hesitate to employ any kind of unscientific method to prove their theory. Bearing this point in mind, when we look at the other so-called evidence of human evolution myth, we confront a similar situation. Here there are a fictional story and an army of volunteers ready to try everything to verify this story.